Hello everyone, good morning. Welcome to Florida, East Coast. Yes. Today's topic is, are you chosen? I spoke about it before, but that's something people need to consider, because many are called, but a few are chosen. And I said because the most common phrase, I'm a good person, I'm going to heaven. I've been in church since this time. My grandma's a pastor, my dad's a pastor. They're praying for me. They see the good in me. They know me. God knows my heart. Those are considered excuses. And Word of God said there's no excuse. People are inexcusable, because just by nature, he reveals himself. Meaning, you see the sun, you see the tree, you see the plants, you see creature. You see the creation. All right, creature. You see the creature. So you see what God created. And when you see these things, the moon, the star, the sky, the storms, the weather, the changes in things, the seasons, the animals, the critters. When you see all this, it gives you awareness that there's a God, because God put it in you to know that he exists. There's something greater than you are that made all this, the oceans, the rivers, the lakes. Like, there's more to it. So with that being said, you can't live your life the way you want to. You can't do what you want, because, you know, it doesn't take all that to serve God. I'm a spiritual person. I do yoga. I follow my ancestors. I follow my culture. It's the Mayan calendar. It's the Ethiopian calendar. It's the African, the Swahilian. This is the real calendar. This is the, like, come on. A day with the Lord is like 1,000 years. And that time that is given to you, that one day, the day you're breathing, you're alive and alert, the Lord gives you space and time to repent. Meaning to reconsider, to change, to have a day, to have time, to have a chance to, like, you know what? I need to change my ways. I need to know how to access this God. And when I do know, and I need to change by what has been told from the Holy Bible, because people like to do research, go on Google, the internet, and look up spiritual stuff, spiritual aspects, how to be a good person, what's good moral, what is ethics. They do this, but they live it out, what the information they find out, and there's no peace in it, there's no love in it, a lot of depression, anxiety, stress. So what they have to do to tolerate that, to subdue it. Yeah, there's addictions, there's entertainment, there's people you go to, especially you use Christians to vent out to, you use anybody to speak to, my psychiatrist, you use medications just to suppress things, you play video games to depress things, you eat to make you feel better, you throw up what you did eat, or you do a lot of things just to keep yourself happy. Keep yourself sane. I gotta just go out, you know? Girls gonna wild, men go wild. Like, I just have to do it sometimes just to vent out, because it's in me. I might as well. I have no shame. What stays in Vegas stays in Vegas. What goes in Vegas stays in Vegas, however that saying is, I don't know. I'm just saying, like, people use these options and do these things that have no results, but yeah, I'm going to heaven. And they're convinced I'm going to heaven. But the Word of God says, many are called. Like, God, he's going to reveal himself to you. But you have to live chosen. You have to live like the person who's going to heaven. You have to love righteousness. You have to love what's good. You have to impute sin. Hate sin. Hate bad things. Hate, loathe what God hates. Like, hey, this is evil. God doesn't like liars. God doesn't like murderers. God doesn't like when people commit suicide. God doesn't like drunkards. God doesn't like manipulators. God doesn't like people who have power, sorcery, witchcraft, divination. The Lord doesn't like that. He doesn't like when people ignore his presence, ignore his name. Like, you know about him, but you don't want to acknowledge him the way he is. Like, he's God, he's sovereign, but no, it's Zeus. It's this God, it's Thor, it's this, Game of Thrones, it's mockery. See, yeah, they have these TV shows, movies to mock God. So when you do hear the truth, that's some fake stuff. That's not real. That's not real. You really believe a man got swallowed by a whale. You really believe the water was open? The Red Sea was open? Come on now. 5 pieces of bread and some fish. You think thousands of people got fed? Come on now. It's impossible. Or, what's worse, those who are in the house of God and those who ignore God, well, those stuff doesn't exist. God doesn't speak to people anymore. That same power we see Jesus do is not. It was only time for when Christianity started. It was needed for the church. Now it has ceased. Yeah, unbelievers and mockers and people blaspheming the Lord. The Word of God said, question not the Spirit. And to not, what to say? Basically, like, push away, ignore prophesying. Like, there's power. People profess godliness, but deny the power thereof. Like, God has power. That's what makes him different from other gods. Like, true power. Power that changes. Yeah, you may have the power to get money, to get riches, to change things, manipulate people, enchant people, charm people. But it's going to be temporary. And you lose your soul in the process for exchange, for the temporary pleasure, temporary time having that power. Because once you're dead, you forsake your force, Satan. And Satan doesn't tell you that. Like, hey, you want to live your life and do this and have fun? All right. And you're going to be in hell with him for eternity. And that's not what the Lord wants from us. That's why he wants to repent. He wants to be faithful. Because remember, there was the 5 foolish virgins and the 5 wise virgins. The foolish thought they had time. They didn't take all of that. Well, I have a little bit of gas. A little oil. It's fine. It's good. And then when it's time to come, hey, can I have some of your oil? Can I have some? Hey, I'm sorry. But all we have is enough for ourselves. Go to the market, see if there's more. So the wise, they went to the bridegroom. And then the unwise, the foolish, they went out to the market to buy the oil. And by the time they came back, he called them already in. The door was shut. And they saw the bridegroom like, hey, we have our oil now. He said, I don't know you. So yeah, those that say I'm a good person, I donate to charity, I help the fatherless, I help the widows, I build houses, I do pantry, I do work. If the people you're influencing are not changing and they're not becoming like Christ, your work is vain.